I'm Julia Child. Welcome to my house. What fun we're going to have baking all kinds of incredible cakes, pies, and breads right here in my own kitchen. Mary Bergen, head pastry chef for Wolfgang Puck Spago Restaurants, demonstrates a basic vanilla chiffon cake with a twist. It's rolled around a chocolate walnut mousse. Yum, yum. See how it's done on Baking with Julia. This is a chiffon cake in the form of a jelly roll rolled around a delicious walnut mousse. And Mary Bergen is going to prepare it from scratch today.
I'm going to start off with 4 egg yolks.
This is going to be the cake batter.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Very simple cake batter. And then we have 1/2 cup of vegetable oil. You can use safflower oil or vegetable oil.
But in the chiffon cake, you never use butter, it's always oil.
Right, because you want to have the shortening in a liquid state at all times, and then it keeps that same texture mm-hmm. when you make it the same day or when you put it in the refrigerator overnight. And then we also have 2 tablespoons of vanilla extract.
That's a lot of vanilla extract.
It is, because it really needs a little bit of some kind of flavor.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, so if you would like to go ahead and whisk that together.
Okay. Just needs mixing, I guess.
Right. Okay, so now let's sift the dry ingredients here. We have 1 cup of all-purpose flour.
Correctly measured.
And then we also have 1 cup of granulated sugar.
Why are you sifting them?
Because I want to keep it nice and light.
You want to make sure.
Right.
They ain't no
and then
mouse.
We also have 1 teaspoon of baking powder.
Double action baking powder.
Right. This is 1/2 teaspoon, so I'll do this twice.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also have 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda.
Why do we need the soda?
Well, it helps to activate it and help it rise.
Mm-hmm. You just like soda.
I like soda. Not diet soda, soda. Get this all sifted out. And I'm also going to add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And since I always use kosher salt in baking, I'm going to add it right to my pile of sifted ingredients.
Now, why do you use kosher salt?
I find that it melts into cake batters a little bit better. And
okay.
You don't have that real iodized salt taste.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we have our dry ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
And if you'll whisk, I'll pour.
All right.
Now, I want to do this gradually because you want to keep it nice and light.
Nice having 2 people.
That's right. Always invite somebody over before you make this cake.
There you are.
And now I'm going to take these nicely whipped egg whites and fold a little bit of this into the batter just to lighten it up a little bit.
You guess you always do that.
Well, the heavier the batter, the more chance you have of deflating your egg whites.
Mm.
So this lightens it up. Now I'll just pour that in here.
I can hold that for you.
Thank you very much. I'm gonna make sure you scrape the bowl all the way. You don't want to leave 1/2 cup of batter behind.
Mm-hmm.
And now we'll fold these all together.
That's always so important of how to fold, isn't it?
Right,
and
you don't want to
turn the bowl.
You want to turn the bowl. You want to always go in the same direction. If you start changing directions, going back and forth, you'll deflate the egg whites, and then you won't have nearly the volume that you need to fill in the pan.
Mm-hmm. And a great big spatula helps, doesn't
Yes, it does. Well, you know, when you make anything, the right tools really make the difference.
You want to make sure you get every bit of it.
Yep.
You know.
We don't want to leave any white streaks.
No.
Okay, now we need that sheet pan over there. We have a nice jelly roll pan that's been sprayed with vegetable spray. Put a layer of parchment paper on that. I sprayed it again, and then I tapped
a little all-purpose flour in there. That looks lovely. Is it going in there? It's nice to know that the standard chiffon cake recipe will do so many things, isn't it?
It's very versatile. You can do all kinds of things with it. As a matter of fact, at Spago in Las Vegas, you can imagine I have requests for wedding cakes all the time.
Oh, yes.
And I really like to use a chiffon cake. And I give people the option of a chocolate chiffon or vanilla or a lemon chiffon. I think so far the lemon chiffon is pretty much the favorite when it comes to a wedding cake.
And there's a nice recipe of yours in our new book that goes with this TV series for the lemon chiffon.
As a matter of fact, there is.
There is, indeed.
Then when you're spreading this out, you want to work quickly, but you want to make sure it's nice and even. And I like to use long strokes as opposed to trying to fit it into the corners. And we'll just give it a little tap.
So there won't be any air bubbles. Then it goes
and then
into
we'll
the
bake
oven.
It in an oven, 350 degrees, 10 to 12 minutes.
Now we're going to do your walnut mousse. Is this your invention?
Yes.
Yeah.
To some extent.
To some extent.
I suppose. I didn't invent mousse, but I think I invented this walnut mousse. Okay, what we're going to do is put 6 ounces or 1 2/3 of a cup of toasted walnuts, lightly toasted, into a food processor. And we'll get those all nice and small. You want to turn it on and off. And then to that, we're going to add some walnut oil.
So you get a fully walnut taste there.
Now, you can add safflower oil if you live in a part of the country that you can't find walnut oil.
No.
And then I would suggest adding a little walnut extract to that. I'm going to process that till a nice paste forms.
It's mostly when you're chopping nuts, you're going to avoid getting them oily. Now
you
want them.
You want the oil to come out in this.
Mm-hmm.
And then over there we have 5 ounces of melted bittersweet chocolate. And I have used melted milk chocolate in this, and it comes out very well.
Oh, either one.
So I'm going to take the top off to add this into it.
Isn't that nice?
And then we'll just process that a little bit more until it's nicely combined. Okay. And we'll just leave that on the side while we make a sugar syrup out of 1/3 cup of granulated sugar and 1/4 cup of water. We'll bring that to a boil, and then we're going to whisk that into our egg yolks, which we have 3 of. And since this is a very small quantity, it will come to a boil quickly. Mm-hmm. Now that our sugar syrup has come to a boil, we're going to start to cook the yolks. We have 3 egg yolks in here, and you may be wondering why I have them in such a big bowl.
I was wondering.
Okay, and I'll explain it to you. We have them in a big bowl because this is the bowl that's going on the machine.
Well,
so we might as well save ourselves a bowl to clean, wouldn't you say?
Yeah. I'm
okay, now you're going to stir that while I pour in the boiling sugar syrup. And it's important that the sugar syrup is boiling when this goes in.
And this should do it very slowly so it's not scrambling.
To hurt the fragile little eggs.
Yes.
And then all we want to do is just whisk that until it's hot to the touch. Okay, now that's hot to the touch, wouldn't you say?
Very.
Okay. Now we'll take it, put it right onto the machine. And we're going to beat that at a high speed until it's doubled in volume. And you want to do this quickly because you want it to cool while it's being whipped. And when I say cool to the touch, all you need to do is feel the bottom of the bowl.
Well, that's hot.
That's still hot.
Yeah. Well, this is a wonderful idea that this machine has. I have to put it up again. This is you can either put boiling water or ice in here. There, that's good. I'm going to put it down again. There.
Oh, now this will make it a little faster, I think.
It certainly will.
I think we're there.
See if it isn't cold. Mm-hmm. It is.
Nice. Okay, now we'll just take this off. Sure cut down the time on that, didn't it?
Oh, it's just wonderful. That's really holding its mm-hmm. shape in there, too. Okay.
All ready for the chocolate and walnut mixture to go in. And now I think we'll use that glass bowl over there so we can get a better picture of it. See how nice and thick that is?
It's lovely, yeah.
Now we'll add our chocolate walnut paste to that. Mm. And then you don't have to worry about this chocolate and walnut mixture sitting too long because the oil in it, and you brought out all the natural oil of the walnuts, it keeps it fairly liquid for quite a while.
Mm-hmm. Tiny little extra there. We'll put it in for you. There's a teaspoon extra.
Okay.
That's all.
We'll just mix this together, and then we'll fold in the cup of cream that we've already whipped. And I'm going to fold as you add that together.
That's going to be awfully nice. That's a real mousse, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Could you make this somewhat ahead?
Oh, sure. You could make this a day ahead easily.
Even with the whipped cream in it?
Mm-hmm.
And just fridge it?
Yeah, and then just give it a nice stir before you use it.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be just fine.
I think we'll have to taste it to see how it is, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Mm, that looks beautiful. That's very useful if you can know you can make that ahead.
Mm. And actually, this is a recipe into itself, too.
It is. You could serve this as a dessert, just as is.
Mm-hmm.
Mm, lovely.
And now we have our filling for our vanilla chiffon roll.
Mm-hmm.
Or roulade. And I'm also going to use caramelized walnuts as the decoration for the top.
Good.
And I'll show you how I do that.
Great. Good.
What we have in this pan is half a cup of granulated sugar. And we're just putting it right over a medium to medium-high flame. And you want to keep it moving all the time because you don't want it to burn in one spot. Because once caramel burns in a...
It's already caramelized, isn't it?
It's very quick.
There's no water in it, or
no, I don't use water, but if you feel more comfortable, if you need that extra time, then it doesn't make any difference. All you have to do is evaporate the water, boil it out.
Well, this is certainly quicker.
And the reason I use a fork instead of a wooden spoon is because I want to be able to break up the sugar crystals. And if you just want to check it every once in a while, hold it up to the light and see the color of your caramel. You want to have it nice and golden.
You have to keep lifting it up so you can see, don't you?
Right. Okay, beautiful. We're there. Okay,
well,
so I have the walnuts on a piece of wax paper. I'm going to do two at a time. So all I need to do is just put that in there, like this, tap it a few times. Rather like dipping truffles in chocolate.
Yeah. This is very easy to do, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. And you want to work quickly because it will end up getting extremely dark after a while.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you a great hint for cleaning out a pot that has caramel in it. What you do is whatever caramel's left over, let it cool off just a little bit, and it will start to harden.
Mm-hmm.
And then take some hot tap water, and then just put it back on the fire and let it boil. And then what it does is that it loosens up all the caramel, and then you just pour it out.
Well, that certainly is very easy.
Okay, and now while these are cooling so we're able to handle them, we're going to roll up our mousse in our vanilla chiffon layer.
Great. Then we'll eat it.
Then we'll eat it.
Great. It's very tender, isn't it?
Nice and soft, and it's still really moist, so we'll be able to roll it easily.
If you overcook it, then it will all crack.
Right. But an easy remedy to that is make a little sugar syrup and then brush it on.
Well, that's a good idea.
And I'll reconstitute it almost. Okay, so the easiest way I find to turn out a sheet pan like this is to just sprinkle a little bit of granulated sugar on top because, as you can feel, it's a little bit on the tacky side.
Yeah.
It's a little wet, and you don't want it to stick to anything. And this kind of helps it to not stick.
I think the big secret of this jelly roll is how to get it out and roll it up.
Well, I'll tell you my big secret if you tell me yours.
I don't have one.
I just take another piece of parchment paper, put that over there, and then invert a pan, another sheet pan. Doesn't have to be exactly the same size, just a little bit bigger is fine.
And upside down. Flip it over. Well, that's very clever.
Voila.
Voila. Now what?
Now what we're going to do is we're going to roll it up.
Yeah.
But we're going to need a little help rolling it up. And I used the original piece of parchment paper. And I'm just going to loosen it.
Can you roll it for either from the short or the long side? Or?
I roll it the long way.
So for more drama.
Otherwise, you'll have a
big, nice one. That's coming off beautifully. That's because it was buttered and floured, I guess.
That's the key.
No.
You don't want to glue it.
No.
And then since this does have the oil on it, the paper, I'm going to use it just to flip it over.
Flip it over again?
Okay. This pan again.
Now why do we need so many flippings?
I'll show you.
Okay.
I could have just taken it off of there and put it right on the table, but then when I'm all rolled up, I need to pick it up and put it into the refrigerator.
That's true.
This makes it a lot easier.
Yeah.
And you don't have to move it too much.
Yes.
It's trial and error. The first time I did this, I didn't do it. Okay, now I'm going to cut off the very edge of it because that's the part that will keep you from getting a really nice roll. And it's important to do this. And then, of course, you need to know what your cake is going to taste like. See, look at this texture. Now, that's a chiffon cake. You want to see all...
Because it does have the holes in it.
Right, you want to see some air pockets in there. You want to see that it's nicely risen.
And it's kind of supple, too, isn't it? Tastes good.
That's the important part.
What do you do with these besides eating them yourself?
Just eat them.
Or if you needed cake crumbs for something.
Oh, sure. You could toast these.
That'd be nice.
Sprinkle them around the sides of the plate for decoration. Would be very nice.
That's not very clever, so now you don't have any edges getting in your way.
Yeah. And you really haven't cut off too much of it either. And now I'm using this paper as my guide to roll it up, which is why I left that paper on in the first place. Now we take our walnut mousse that has been chilled for a few hours.
And that looks lovely. That is sort of very light and with nice holes in it.
And take it.
You always want these, what they call
offset spatulas. Okay, now we're going to start it by just folding that over ever so slightly. And then using this, we just help ourselves along. And then lift it up. And then we have our nice roll. Now you want to keep this pretty tight. And what I do at this point is just take a fork and then just tuck the paper in underneath. And then we're going to refrigerate this for a few hours.
It's otherwise you'll never be able to slice it.
And I don't have to pick it up. All I have to do
that's
is
wonderful.
Take the tray.
Okay.
And then we'll put it in the refrigerator and then we'll decorate it.
Okay. Here she comes.
Here we go. It's all nice and cold. It's been in the refrigerator for 2 hours. Now we can unwrap it. See how nice that is? It's all sealed.
How long can you leave it in the fridge?
Oh, you could leave it in overnight.
Could you freeze it?
You could. And then I would suggest thawing it out in the refrigerator instead of at room temperature. Okay, so I'm going to decorate right on here because we're going to put it on this beautiful white platter. I'm just going to trim the edges. And again, you always need to have your tasting pieces, right?
does.
And then I've taken little strips of parchment paper.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to lay those straight across. And you can do any kind of pattern for this, too. You don't have to have perfectly made strips. You can have strips at an angle. And then I'm going to take some cocoa powder.
Oh, I see, yes.
Put that on
and
there.
And then the strips keeps it on cocoa.
Mm-hmm.
That's a nice idea. Do you use any special cocoa?
I like to use a good quality cocoa, mm-hmm. because the better the quality, the darker.
Oh, yes.
The darker it is. And then I'm also going to take a little confectioner's sugar and just a little teeny bit of that, like it's snowing.
Mm-hmm.
This would be a good Christmas dessert, wouldn't you say?
It certainly would, yes.
And now I'm going to carefully take off these pieces of parchment.
Well, that's nice, isn't it?
And if you make this with a chocolate chiffon,
mm.
we can do just powdered sugar,
mm-hmm.
and then it really stands out. It looks like a nice
mm-hmm.
striped roll.
There are those walnuts.
Okay, and now we'll just place the walnuts. Oh,
those make a very nice decoration.
Isn't that pretty?
Yeah.
And now you have this wonderful spatula,
mm-hmm.
so I am going to attempt to pick this up.
And don't ask me where it came from, because I don't know. It's wonderful.
Oh, we'll just place that there. And since it is cold and right out of the refrigerator, it's very
mm-hmm.
easy to move.
Yeah.
Then we'll just decorate this with
Get
some mint sprigs. In the wintertime, it would be great to have some cranberries.
Mm-hmm.
Just throw some cranberries around on the plate. Now I think we should try it.
I do, too. We're going to do
okay,
this.
Okay, so I'm going to give us a nice big slice. Put it on this plate.
Mm. That is a nice big slice. Well, that's
a little
very,
garnish.
Very nice. Now, shall we dig in?
I think we should.
Be sure. And that's... Mmm. That's a lovely kind of subtle feeling,
mm-hmm.
isn't it? Mm-hmm. Lovely.
Good combination, I would say.
I'm delighted to see this dessert. I never thought of a chiffon cake as a jelly roll in this lovely
walnut. It works really well.
Oh, very, very well. I think the walnuts are a wonderful idea. Delicious. Mary, thank you very much. Well, you've given us a very good lesson, and I thank you.
My pleasure.
Bon appétit!